Hello guys, in this video I'm going to show how to scrape RSS feeds easily from web. So first of all, what is RSS? RSS means rich site summary. So various websites use their RSS feeds to publish the frequently updated information, right? Like your blog entries or the news headlines or some kind of audio or video. So this is where RSS feeds are mainly used. So we can use that RSS feed to extract some important information from a particular website. So for example, in this video I will be showing you how you can extract the RSS feeds of a news website, right? So basically you will be getting the news headlines from a website easily using some RSS feeds, right? So I'm going to use the RSS feeds of a news website called Hindustan Times. So let's see. So at the RSS, most of the websites have RSS endpoint at which they contain all the links to their RSS feeds, and here I'm going to use the top stories RSS feed. So look at that, this is a top stories RSS feed. So actually it's a XML file and it's been just represented in a bit more prettier way, but basically it's an XML file and you can get that from this thing, that it is rssfeed.xml, right? So this is how it looks. So let's see how we can scrape this file, right? So let me just copy this URL. Okay, so I've already imported the things we will be needing here. I've imported the request library and I've imported the beautiful soup library. So I'm just defining the URL as this, and now I'm just going to create a, I'm just going to make a get request and get the response object. So requests dot get, and I'm just going to pass URL. Okay, let me just run it again. So now I have the response object with me. So what I can do now is I'm going to create a soup object, a beautiful soup object, basically like this, beautiful soup response dot content. And another thing is that by default beautiful soup is used for parsing HTML files, right? But here we are going to parse a XML file, so you will have to use another argument called features and set it as XML, right? So this is how you do it. Okay, now let me just show you the XML file that we have just parsed. Soup dot prettify is what I am going to use to show you. Okay, so this is the XML file that we have just parsed from here, right? So as you can see, it contains a lot of data, but what I am interested in is the news items, right? And as you can see that this item tag contains all the data about a particular news item, right? So there are several item tags like this, like here another one, right? So like this, there are many item tags, and that is what I want to extract from here, right? So let's see what we can do to do that. Okay, so what I'm going to do is that I'm going to create a list called items, which will contain all the you can say the snippets of the item tags. So it is soup.findAll item, so it will find all the item tags and give you the XML data inside it. So let me just check the length of the items. It's 15, right? So it means that there are 15 news items here. So just for the demonstration purpose, I'm going to write item is equal to items 0 to show you how to deal with a single news item. So item is this. Item contains title here, right? Then it contains a short description about this news headline, right? Then we have a link of that news on hindustantimes.com, and we also got a publishing date of that news article, and then we got the URL of the image for that news headline, right? Like this. So this is the data that I want to extract now. So what I'm going to do is that basically You have to understand that it is a hierarchical structure in the HTML and XML files. So if I've got the item, then title tag is inside it. The title is inside the item. So to get the title, I can just use item.title, right? So item is the parent, title is a child. So I can do item.title and I get the title. And to retrieve just the text, I can do item.title.text, right? So similarly, I can do this thing for description and link as well, right? But in case of media, I think you are going to have a bit of difficulty, because here the data is inside the attributes of that tag itself, right? So one more detail here is that it contains something different from other ones, is a colon here, media colon content, right? So basically XML files have something called namespace. So namespace is used when we want to just use a complete URL for a single thing. Like here it is media, right? So actually let me show you. Print soup.prettify. Okay, so here RSS XML namespace media has this value. The value is this http search.yahoo.com/mrss, right? So this is how namespaces are used, and we can ignore that namespace completely. So what is left is the content. So the basic tag of this batch XML is content. So I can just write item.content. So item.content will give me that data, right? And in order to extract some attribute of a tag, you can use URL. You can use it like a dictionary. So I'm just passing the key URL to get this complete URL, right? So look at that, I got the URL, right? So this is how we can simply parse a particular news item, right? So here I've already written the code for making another list of dictionaries in which each dictionary contains the complete news item, right? So I'm just making a empty list here first. So as you can see in this code, it will iterate through each item, and a news item dictionary is made. It's empty, and then I fill it with all that data, and then I simply append it to the news items list. So if I just run that and try to see the news items, so look at that, I got a list of dictionaries where each dictionary contains the information about that particular news story, right? So let me just see the first news item. Look at that, it's a simple dictionary which contains the keys called description, image, link, title, right? So this is how you can easily parse the XML files, and or basically you can say RSS feeds, which are nothing but XML files, and then you can save that data in a more better way, right? So that's it from this video. I hope you liked it. Thanks for watching.